Hello guys, today it brings me great sadness to start the day with some bad news, some sad news. Unfortunately, one of our meerkats drowned. One of our meerkats drowned. You can see just there, just under the webcam. It's a sad day, so let's just take a minute to remember the fun times we had with our little meerkat. As if that wasn't bad enough. I've just taken a moment to mourn our meerkat and the other one that's drowned. What is going on? What is life? Oh my god, guys, this is not how I wanted to start the episode. In my hand, I hold our past meerkat. Let's quickly go grab the other one. Shh. Where are you? Oh, the same place that the last one drowned. It's so sad. They're drowning together. Oh my god. We're gonna have to hold a memorial for them. We're gonna have to bury these guys and have a grave. We're gonna have to lay the little guys to rest around here, I think, near the pathway, so people can see and remember our little friendos. Let me just place their coffin. Place them in the coffin together. Like they live life together. Happy, loving, perfect creatures. Okay, to move past this sadness, I think we're gonna have to carry on with what we had going, just to try and work through the grief. Rest in peace, meerkats. You will never be forgotten. In your honor, we will build the greatest tiger enclosure ever. So coming back to the tiger enclosure, we have it all mapped out already. Now it's just about beautifying it, building up the walls, and yeah, making it a great place for our two tigers to live and be happy. So I'm thinking somewhere we need like a wash pool area. We need a bunch of like trees for them to lay under, keeping the shade. You know, they love the jungle, so we're gonna keep it sort of that sort of theme, not too dissimilar to the leopard enclosure. And then they're gonna have like a little rock formation that they can lay on. I think that's gonna be it. But first, we're gonna have to do the walls. So you can see here, I've got a bunch of stone bricks, a bunch of glass, and exhibit glass. So we're gonna try and get that done first. And hopefully, it looks good. And this is it, guys. One finished, or not finished, one completed enclosure border. And also a way in as well. I've got this here, again, similar to the leopard enclosure, except this time I couldn't put it directly next to it because this enclosure is an entire walk around. Guests are going to be able to walk through the entire thing. Come through here, you get a view of each one, and there's a pathway that goes all the way around. Hence the tall glass. We don't want people jumping into the tiger enclosure. We can't have that kind of PR issue. So yeah, down straight into here, double door system so we don't lose anything. Close the first door before you open the second. And here we are. One reinforced wall with glass and redwood topper. I think it looks great. Now we've got to kind of pretty the place up. I've got a few leftover stone here. And I was going to do sort of like a stony area. Maybe go get some cobbles. Do I have cobblestone on me? No. Put some cobblestone and other sort of bricks, stones in here. And then this can be sort of like a little platform area for them. They can jump up here and look all majestic and look out at the tasty looking guests. So yeah, next up is to decorate this place. I also decided to tame a couple horses. I think I'm gonna introduce some like horse slash pony rides. I'll put it just here near the seating area. So once the kids are done eating, then come have a nice little pony ride. Also, side note on that, this white horse here, potentially the fastest horse I've ever had in Minecraft. It is crazy fast. It's mental. Look at it. It's going crazy. But that's enough of that. Okay, so in terms of prettifying, excuse me. We have everything that's in my hotbar. So I've got a few different types of stone. I've got some ostrich fern and some white anemone. or anemone, whatever it's called. I've got some of this cool plant. I've got some glowstone to light the area. I think we're going to do that first. And I've got some eucalyptus wood, just to sort of maybe put some like logs down, kind of like this. I thought it would be kind of cool. Have a sort of... like this, maybe. And I have these little wood blocks to put over. Let's put this down. I need my shovel. Let's put one there. One there. One in this corner. One over here. One here. One behind. One either side of the rocky bit. I think that should do in terms of glowstone and lighting up the area. Might need one in the middle, to be honest. We'll have a look once we've laid it all. Okay, I'm going to go for one right here too. And I think that'll do for the glowstone. This, just jump around and place it randomly. Boop, like that, easy. Same with this stuff. This is how you decorate. This is how I've been decorating, just kind of been spamming. You know, just doing stuff like this. I want mostly these fans. Lovely. Okay. Last but not least, let's put some of these rocks down. This one and a cheeky bit of andesite. Perfect. I think that'll do. There we go. Okay. Done. So that's the rocky area done. That's the lighting done. That's the scenery done. So next, I think we need some trees in here. I think we need some trees, so I need to go back and grab some tree pods to grow those. And I need to put a couple of food barrels in here and a couple of things for them to play from, which I don't think we'll be able to do until the trees are grown. So the tire swings might have to wait for a little while. We'll see. Okay, since we went for a eucalyptus sort of food on logs here, I thought I'd plant some eucalyptus pods. Also, that's obviously what I had, so I think we're just going to go for two. I think eucalyptus trees get quite big. Maybe I'll put one there too. Why not? Yeah, so we'll go for those. I also got these just leaves that I thought I could plop around here, maybe. Just like this. I think that's cool. That looks like a fallen... couple of fallen trees and stuff. I like it. Move these bits as well. Cool. There we go. I think that's it. I think now... I have the food barrel too. I just need to... I need at least two of those saved. So let me just put the food barrel. I'm not going to put it underground. I'm going to put it directly in the center. Chuck those in. Space them out a bit. There we go. So the food is ready for them. I just need to find two raw beef to make the cat big cat kibble. Because you need these. And obviously I've got two. So I just need to... oh, these are growing quick. Just need to find two raw beef. And then we'll have the big cat kibble. And they'll be ready to release and tame straight away. Right, I'm home. We're ready to craft this wonderful big cat kibble, if I can remember how to do it. I think it was like this. Nope, how was it? Like this. Okay, put the beef in. It took me over 1,500 blocks. 1,500 blocks to, or 1,500 meters, whatever they call it, on Minecraft to find these friggin' cows. What a pain in the butt. However, on the way I did have some surprises that I will hold on to until next episode. Hang on a second. Someone's escaped. What did you hear me with? Slowness. I need a net. Oh god. How did he escape? I can't sleep. Of course I can't. Die. Die, bitch! Where'd he go? Squish! What do you think you're doing? No! Oh god, it's a catastrophe! Run! Ugh. 30 seconds until our slowness. God damn it. Squish, what are you doing to us? What are you doing to us? Well, no taming the tigers yet. I guess we gotta wait for all this to blow over. Alright, it's daytime, we can leave the house. Come over this way. How hectic. How did Squishmitten even... How did she even escape? Stay. Wait, hang on a second. What? Oh, okay. That was weird. You okay there, Squish? God damn it. Let's put that back down. No more escaping. Bad Squishmitten. Jeez Louise. Okay, back to the business at hand. Taming tigers. It would help if I brought the tigers with me to tame. Alright, we're in. Our eucalyptus trees are growing nice and tall. It's time to release these bad boys. Ow. Oh no. Please tame. Oh god. Oh. Okay, that was close. I need to heal up. God damn it, dude. Why you gotta hurt me like that? Let's have a look. Let's read some stuff about you. An impish male. You truly are an impish male. So they eat all kinds of meat. And they're rich with scratching posts. We could do some scratching posts instead of tires in this one. That'd be quite nice. Okay. Next. Let me tame you. Wait, are you already tame? Oh, he's already tame. I don't remember taming you, but sure. We got two boyos. Two big boyo tigers. Loving life. Well, look at them. They got everything they need except some scratching posts. I guess I'll go make those and put that in the enclosure, and that is another enclosure done. And the final one can go here by the rocks, I think. You're over there, buddy. There we go. One target enclosure complete. I think that's it for today. We've had quite an eventful time. We've sadly lost some meerkats. We had an escape. And we had some nice releases. So a bit of a mixed bag. I'm going to do some stuff in between the next two episodes. So you have some surprises to come back to. I think you're going to enjoy it. I know I certainly am. So until next time, stay safe. Love you guys lots. Peace, bye.